It is attached to the anther, so that is known as adhesion. This filament is attached to the anther is known as adhesion. It is different types, okay, based on that different flowers of the plant, okay. After that, anther wall. So these are the microsporangia. This is the structure of that anther wall. The structure of anther wall. So we take that one point. It's that layers of anther wall. Thank you. right? So in the structure of that anther, stamen and microsporangium of anther and pollen grain. In the structure of microsporangium and anther wall, so generally first one is that anther wall having mainly four layers. First one is the epidermis, second one is the endothecium, third one is the middle layer, fourth one is the tapetum. Generally in the structure of the microsporangium, mainly two parts. First one is the anther wall, second one is the sporogenous tissue. Okay. In the structure of microsporangium, mainly, okay, two parts. First one is the anther wall. So, second one is the sporogenous tissue. So, this anther wall is different, okay. So, having that dense layer structures, this anther wall having mainly four layers. First one is that in layers of the anther wall, first one is that epidermis. So this epidermis is single layer. So the cells are arranged, okay. So in the sequence, the single layer, okay, without spaces. So that is known as epidermis. In that epidermis, some cells are large and thin. They are known as the stomium cells. These stomium cells are present. So where the two pollen sacs are connected, so these are the pollen sacs. Where the two pollen sacs are connected in the epidermis, some cells are thin and large. They are known as that stomium cells. Stomium cells are present in epidermis of anther, anther wall. So at the time of maturity of the anther, so anther is dehiscence at the stomium. It is helped for dehiscence of the anther. At the mature condition of the anther, dehiscence at which place? Stomium. So that is the object to beat. So epidermis providing protection to that anther. So and also it help for dehiscence of that anther. Okay, due to the presence of stomium. Stomium is present between the two pollen sacs. After that, endothecium. Endothecium is present, so below that epidermis. So in this endothecium, cells are fibrous thickenings. Fibrous thickenings and showing of that hygroscopic nature. And showing of that hygroscopic nature. So in that hygroscopic nature, due to the presence of hygroscopic nature at the time of dehiscence of that anther, okay, so these cells are become contract and helped in that dehiscence of anther. At maturity, cells loss of water become contract and help to split off anther. Split off anther. So that is known as that endothecium. Fibrous thickenings, hygroscopic nature present. So characters are present in the endothecium. It is the second layer of that epidermis. After that, so third layer. So this third layer is known as that middle layer. So middle layer is providing protection and it is also helped for that dehiscence of anther. So innermost layer, this innermost layer is known as that tapetum. It is that fourth layer. So this tapetum having that, okay, more amount of food material It provides nourishment to the development of that pollen grains. So more amount of food material, protoplasm, dense protoplasm, dense protoplasm and binucleate condition. These are objective bit. It producing hibiscus bodies, they are helping formation of that exine wall in the pollen grain. Okay, so what are the main function of the tapetum? Tapetum providing nourishment to the development of that pollen grain due to the presence of food material, and it is at a binucleate. Okay, so next, it provide formation of exine wall of pollen grain. Exine is outer layer of pollen grain. Okay, so by the producing of hibiscus bodies, hibiscus bodies are produced from tapetum. It is objective bit. They are helped in formation of exine layer. So it means why they are that binucleate condition. After nuclear division, cytoplasm means our cytokinesis not occur. That's why each cell having more than one nuclei. So that is known as that binucleate condition. Okay, that is that objective bit. After that is known as that anther wall. Okay, after that, so that is known as a sporogenous tissue. Sporogenous tissue, it is a homogeneous tissue. Homogeneous parenchyma tissue is known as the sporogenous tissue. So this sporogenous tissue convert into that microspore mother cell. Microspore mother cell. This microspore mother cell absorbing food material, okay, from the tapetum. Then each microspore mother cell undergoes meiotic division, producing four haploid spores. That is known as, so they do not separate, so they are combined, okay, at that Enger condition, in that Enger anther. So that is known as that four microspores are formed. So that is known as that undergoes meiotic division, four microspores are formed. They are known as microspore tetrad. After that, at mature condition, by the dissolving of callose layer by callase enzyme, so then loss of water, then microspores are developed to pollen grain. Developed to that pollen grain. Okay, so at that time of mature condition, then anther is split, then pollen grains are released from that anther. So that is known as completely structure of microsporangium and also layers of that anther.